Okay, this is just a short video on how to record a macro in Excel. How to record a macro in Excel. So, the reason why would you want to record a macro in Excel? Well, it's basically if you are doing something repetitive, and you don't want to enter the keystrokes over and over again, right? So suppose I have an Excel spreadsheet here, right? And I want to color certain cells a certain color, right? In some kind of random matter, right? So let's do this, just do this here. I just want some random numbers here. Okay, so suppose I want to color certain squares red. I want to record a macro to do that. Okay, so I go to macros, and then I want to. This is a list of all the macros. Right now, I don't have any macros in this worksheet, right? So I want to record a macro. So I click on this button here, which says "Record Macro." See, it has the little red dot there, which is like a record button on a tape recorder. And I'll call this MCR for macro red because it's going to be a macro to turn the cell red. Okay. Oh yeah. So we'll take this cell here. Then we'll change the background color to red. So here's the background color, and we'll make it red, right? And suppose we also want to do some other things, right? We want to change the font to Aharoni. We want to change the size to 24. We want to change the boldness to bold. We want to turn on the italics. We want to turn on the underline. And we want to make it centered, right? So suppose that we want to do all those things, right? Now I can stop the macro here. I have to go to back to the developer tab, and this is the stop button, right? The same position where the record button was before is the stop button now. And so now I have that macro. If I click on macros, this is a list of my macros, and I have one macro, which is this one here, right? Now I also, okay, I want to edit it. So I'll go to Edit, and it shows me the VBA window, right? The Visual Basic for Applications window showing me the VBA commands, right? It's the red macro, right? It goes to cell D5, right? But actually, we want it to go to different cells. So I'll comment out that line. I comment it out by putting a single quote at the beginning of the command, because anything to the right of a single quote is a comment, right? So this is a comment, right? These are all comments, right? Because they start with a single quote, right? So what it's doing here is on the selection interior object, it's setting the values of these properties, right? Each of these is a property, right? It's setting the pattern property to solid, setting the pattern color index property to automatic. This is the important one. It's setting the color property to 255, which means red, right? Now, since that's not intuitively obvious, I'll put a comment in here, right, to say that 255 means red, right? That's the end of this width. Here's the beginning of the width, and here's the end of the width, right? Then the next one is doing stuff to the selection font, right? It's setting it to Aharoni because that's the one that I chose, right? And these are the other properties that are not so important, right? Then next, with the font, it's setting the size to 24, right? 24 is the important property here. The other ones are not so important. Then setting the bold property to true, it's setting the italic property to true, setting the underline property to true, right? Now, if you wanted to make this a little bit more clear for yourself or for anyone else, then you can put a comment in here, bold, italic, right? Same with up here. You can put in a comment here, big font, right? And the last thing was we're setting the alignment to center, right? Here's where we're setting the alignment to center. So these are all of the VBA commands for that macro. Now I can save the macro in the VBA window. I can close the VBA window. Remember, the VBA window is a separate window from the Excel worksheet. Now I want to set this. I'm using Excel 2010 here. It should be a macro enabled workbook, XLSM, file extension XLSM, right? If you use XLSX, that means no macros, right? So you're running the chance of having the macro not work, because if it's a macro, it should be in a macro enabled workbook. This is just a test, so I'll just call this file test test, and I'll save it here. Now close the VBA window. Right now we should also set a shortcut key for that macro, right? So under options, I'll set, so maybe I can make it a Q, right? So what this means is that when I press Control Shift Q, it'll execute this macro. And under the description, I'll say this macro turns the background color red, etc. Right. Okay, we'll save that. Close this. So if I go to this cell here and I do Control Shift Q, it does all of those things. It sets the background color red, and it does all of the other things that I specified when I recorded the macro. Same here, I can go here, Control Shift Q. Right. Same thing here, Control Shift Q, right? So if you've got anything that you do over and over again, Control Shift Q, then you can just record a macro to do that. And it can go on. You could do hundreds of commands in there. If you have like a very, very complicated sequence of commands, but you do the same commands every time, then you can record a macro to do that. You just start recording the macro, go through all of the commands, and then stop recording the macro when you're finished, right? So that's the lesson for today. I'll save this again, and thanks for watching.